What's up, my friends? Welcome on Travels and Code channel. Today, in this video, I will show you the solution for LeetCode, the first task, to sum. This solution will be created using JavaScript language. So, let's start. What do we need to do? We have an array, and we need to find two indices to get result. So, values for these indices, we need sum up and get target. So, we have array, and we have target, what we need to add. We have three different solutions for this task. The first one is the easiest, so we need just get one number and go one by all elements and sum these elements and compare with target. If we will get the target, we have these indices. This one it calls brute force, and it's the easiest one for understanding how it works. So let's implement it. So we need the first cycle. So we go one by one. Then we need the second cycle, because in the first one we will get the first number, for example 2. Then we need to go by each of these numbers and compare with target. So 4. But here is a very important part. So let's create J. We will start from I, then nums. Why we started from I, not 0? Let me show you some sample with console. So we have this array. Okay, we have it, and let's output this array by a cycle. So we have this square matrix, and we need to compare each number. So first of all, we need to compare 2 plus 7. Why? Because all we know that you may not use the same element twice. So we don't compare 2 plus 2. We need to compare 2 plus 7 is 0 and 1. And we will get 9. So it's okay. Then we need to compare 2 plus 11 and 2 plus 15. Then we will go to checking the next sum. The next number is 7 plus 2. But we already compared 2 plus 7, so it's the same number. It means that we do not need to compare it again, because so we know that we will get result or not. So it means that we need just numbers from this section. It's this one, 7, 11, 15, and this small part, because of all other parts we already compared. So we need to just check 7 plus 11, but we don't need to check 11 plus 7, for example. It means that that's why we are using just a half of this array. It's the easiest one. So now we need just if nums I plus nums j is it target, just return I j. So it's the easiest one. Let's run. So it's wrong. Why? Because of on the first cycle we will get I 0 and J 0. It will be the same number 2, but we don't need to use the same number as it was mentioned before. So we need to add plus 1. So it means that we will go to 2 and plus 7. We will skip the first 2 on the second cycle. Let's run again. Oh, we have one mistake. Let's fix it and let's run. So, expected, we got what we needed, and now we can submit this result. Let's check. So, okay, it works, but what do we see? That we have runtime 148 milliseconds, and it's faster than only 23.5%. It's a very small result, because we are using very bad solution. So now let's improve this solution with another one. So the complexity of this solution, is n square. Why? Because we need to go twice by each element in this array. So the biggest array we have, the biggest number of cycles we needed. But it's a very bad approach, and we need to skip from this approach. Okay, how we can improve it? First of all, we can remove one cycle and save these numbers into the object or in hash map. But in JavaScript we don't have hashes, we have objects. Okay, so let's create this hash. It's regular object. Then we need to go and we need to initialize this indices object with values. So as index, we will have value. For example, it will be 2, and value will be 0. For index 7, we will have value 1. It's the easiest one. And the second one, this cycle, we need to go once and compare. Will we have a second number? So let's const. We need target minus nums I. So to get target, we need to find the second element, and we can target minus this current number, and we will get this number. And if we have these numbers in this number in our object, we can get it by index because of its index. And if we have it, we will have a current index what we need to show. So it's pretty easy. So if we have an index, if we have this index, we can return index and index getting by. So we pass to this number and we will get index. But what's wrong in this case? For example, for the first one, we will have index 2, but value will be 0. In this case, indices from 2, for example, we will get 0 and this condition will be false. So we need to add additional condition. So if it's not undefined, the first one and the second one, what's important, we don't need to use the same element twice. So and index is not indices complement. Okay, let's run it. We have a small error because we have I instead of index. So it works. Now let's run it. Submit. So we have better result because we have 80 milliseconds and it's faster than 56%. So right now we have complexity by time it's O n because we have n elements in our array nums and we go it just once. Once here and once here. So complexity will be O1. Now it works faster. Even we can update this cycle a bit with for each. Let's check how it works. We will have item and index. And for this case, it's item. And this one, it will be index. We can remove this section. Let's run. Oh, yes. It's a function, don't forget. Okay, it works. Let's run. And result is the same. So, what code looks a bit another. But sometimes, if you submit, you can get another result. Okay, anyway, and the third one, the best case how we can solve this task. Right now we have two cycles, but even in this case, we can skip one of them. So how it works? We have our object with indices, and we are checking if current item on current iteration, if this iteration is what we need by target minus this iteration. So right now we are going forward. If we have element, we return this index and any index from these nums, from this indices object. But we can do it in a bit another way. So let's rename it. First of all, let's change indices from object to another approach. It will be new map. So we can use as well as map object, as well just regular object. Then only in one cycle, let's remove this section. First of all, we need to add the same value complement to indices map. So after if, we need set key will be nums I, it's our value, and the index will be I. It's the same what we had before, but in this case we check if indices, if we have complement. In this case, we will return what's important, indices get complement, and the second one, it will be I. And if we don't have it, we just add this item to array. How it works? In this case, we go backward because of when we have our 2, for example, right now we don't have 7. On the first iteration, we don't have 7 in our indices map. So we go to the next step, then we check 7, and we already have 2. Because of we added this number 2 in the previous iteration, so now we have it. And when we have it, we can just return these values, but here, as you see, first we return value from map, it was the previous one, it will be 0 for 2, and then we return current value, it's I, and right now it's 1 will be for 7. It means that, first of all, we check the next number and compare it with previous one. In this case, we can skip one cycle for initialization indices map, and it should work. So this one, it will have the same complexity by time, it's on. So complexity will be the same, but we removed one cycle and it should work faster. So all these solutions you can find in my GitHub. So we see that we have time for all approaches. For the first one, it was brute force. We have time, we have for two paths, hash table, in our case is JS object, and one path hash table, the same JS object, but we use map. And we see that how much time it takes, and complexity from time and space perspective. And we can open solution the same, and we will get similar approach with calculation how much time and what the complexity it is. So subscribe my channel and thank you for watching, and soon you will see the next solutions for LeetCode tasks and problems. So see you.